put up, put out, and down. Carefully.
Looks good, right?
Yeah, it's not bad. I like how this technique came out. It looks good, and I like it.
Which one?
No, to me, to me, to me, to me. Yeah. Good.
Put some windows on this thing.
Supposedly just got little holes poked in it for windows.
It's logo time. Frankie, steam around for me. The finishing touch is truly old school piping. I mean, that old school piping is gonna tie everything together. All right, guys, all done. What do you think?
Oh, it's
beautiful. I think
beautiful.
It looks good.
Oh, yeah. It'll work. I like all the different textures that are playing around on this cake.
What I love about it is I think we're combining the old world into the new. I think they're gonna love it. I honestly can't wait to go there and check it out.
How are you gonna get it there?
We're gonna put it in a rowboat. Danny's gonna take it.
Danny's gonna row it.
You're gonna take it on a boat?
Be a long boat ride. Flying again. To tell you the truth, I'm a little nervous. Normally, me or one of my guys is with the cake the whole trip. But this time, we're gonna have to crate it up, dry ice it, and trust it to a courier to get it all the way to Saudi Arabia. Me and Mauro ain't gonna see this cake again until we're actually at the event. We just gotta do what we gotta do and hope for the best. Off to Saudi Arabia it goes. Our bags are packed. We're off to Saudi Arabia, baby. Mauro and I got a 12-hour flight direct from New York all the way to Jeddah, which is on the coast of the Red Sea.
So this is, as you can see, houses on your right, on your left. Most of them, they are from 100 to 500 years.
And let me tell you, it's pretty cool here. Not every day I get to go to Saudi Arabia.
Ready, Omar? Get in there. Let's do it.
I got a message that the cake is on the ground, but it's still got to clear customs and get through everything. I just hope it gets to the conference on time.
As you can see, the street is narrow like any historical city in the world, but it gives you this feeling of being in an old town.
In the meantime, the Mist people set up a sightseeing tour for us.
These beautiful windows that we call Roshan, and it comes from the Persian word Razan, the light. So we will have the chance to enter a house, so you can see the light, the ventilation coming from these big windows.
Please, after you.
Yes, please.
Wow, look at the ceiling, Mauro.
As you can see, this is the typical sitting room. Have a seat, please.
I'd love a seat, please. You got it. Actually brought me in and showed me how people lived 100 or 150 years ago. Now, would I take my shoes off or?
No, this one, no.
So this is like their living room. You get comfortable here.
Yes, here our colleague, Mrs. Boudour is going to serve the Arabic coffee.
Excellent.
And I hope you will judge so nicely our Lamar with the sweets.
You know what this looks like, Mauro?
Throne.
We make something like this in Italy, like a Taroni.
This is pistachio? Yes.
Yeah. Exactly that. We cook the sugar with the nuts. Before I went to the Middle East, I gotta be honest, I didn't know what to think. But until you go there and you meet the people and you see the culture and you understand them and you know, you find that you have so much more in common. This is pretty cool. Really, really amazing looking around here. I'm really curious to see like what kind of cakes they do here, what's traditional and kind of what's new. So my host set up a visit to Munch Bakery. How old are you? 7? That's so cool. My son Carlo, he's 5. Their family owned and operated bakery, just like Carlo's back in Hoboken.
Arabic style.
Arabic style.
It's called the mahalabia.
Okay, mahalabia. And also this one, this has got rose water.
Okay. And you have some lemon.
What's the
rose water?
It's
pistachio.
Pistachio?
Where we go?
Okay, this is good. What is that?
munch melt.
What?
I don't know.
You go into this factory, and I gotta tell you, I was so impressed.
What's on top?
Lotus. Lotus. Fresh lotus cookie.
Yeah.
Biscuit.
I was really impressed with not only the quality of the cakes and the cupcakes, but the cake decorating there was top-notch.
I gotta tell you, the integrity of the work that you guys do here is phenomenal.
Awesome.
Really, really nice.
The cake decorators were doing amazing stuff. It really reminded me of my factory. I almost felt at home in Saudi Arabia, being in the factory, you know? Felt like my factory.
I can't thank you enough for your hospitality, my friend. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
High five, bro. Give me... All right. Awesome.
All right, so definitely we're going to do hazelnut.
Hazelnut. Hazelnut for sure.
We want to do apple cinnamon? You guys never did this before, right?
No. We never had different flavors.
Hey, guys. What are you doing?
Flavored lobster tails.
We're trying to come up with different flavors of tails.
Wait a minute. The lobster tail is our signature pastry. Yeah. If it's not broke, don't fix
it. There's still going to be the original lobster tail. And then there's going to be other flavors.
Lobster tails have a very special place in my heart. Not only is it our signature pastry, but my dad developed it. What are these flavors?
Oh, that's what we're working on.
We're trying to figure it out.
Is this pistachio?
This is mint.
It's mint.
Oh, no.
There will be no mint lobster tails. Try this one.
So the original flavor of the lobster tail is actually our traditional French cream. So our French cream is this vanilla bean custard mixed with whipped cream and sugar. It's super simple. And then from that base, we're creating subset flavors from there.
That's bubble gum.
You don't like that?
No, you don't think so?
Ow.
No.
What is this, Chad?
Caramel popcorn.
Caramel popcorn! Just try it!
I don't see these going in tails.
Oh, what is that?
I like carrot.
Oh, my God.
I think the ratio might be a little off on that one.
Is that good?
Oh! It just tasted like antifreeze. It was horrible.
Call me back in when you have some real flavors to taste, okay?